7 months ago, I couldn't find a job. It was harder for me to find a job because of the pandemic and because of my visa. So I decided to learn how to sew. And with the help of my mother-in-law, I learned how to sew scrunchies really fast. So I started my small business, and now it's my full-time job, and I'm making a living out of this.
I don't know why I got so much hate on my packaging in one of my recent packing videos. I think my packaging is really contemporary. No plastic, recycled boxes, only one tissue paper, a reusable lace bag for the customers to store the item in, and of course a thank you card and sticker. But that's normal, that's branding. I mean guys, how should I pack it? Should I better throw it in a plastic bag like most big companies do? I am a small business, I truly care about my customers and I want them to feel loved and appreciated. And no, trust me, my packaging is really not more expensive than
you have to start boosting packaging videos. It's too hard for small businesses to record and package orders at the same time unless you have fancy equipment or someone else to hold the camera, because these videos take time but it only takes a second to share.
Sending scrunchies to someone who's on Netflix. Can you guess who it is? Fine, I'll give you some hints. The first season of the show just came out recently. It was filmed in Canada, in the province that I'm from. The show has total girl boss vibes. They are so inspiring as a woman.
All you need to start doing is building your new life, starting today and moving forward. Wipe the slate clean. What kind of work do you want to be doing? Where do you want to be living? Who do you want to be? You start really investing in yourself. You start building. Get out of the ruins. Get out of the ruins of what's gone and start building.
I made so many scrunchies thinking they'd sell out. I thought they were cute. Look, plants and bee designs. Crinkle, crinkle. Pulls tell me they're cute.
Thoughts about not selling a single scrunchie since I started. Are my scrunchies ugly? Are they too expensive? Should I just quit? Why doesn't my family and friends support me? Just keep going, it will get better.
I want you to know I have a small business, though it may be small. My products hit different, yeah, if you shop small, you see a big difference. So come on, let's go. If you want to support, I can copy link. It makes a big difference, much more than you think.
Here's how I made 600 paper brown packaging bags for my business for only $20. You might have to rewatch this video. I attached all the supplies I used in the comments. Follow for more business hacks.
You're a small business owner, you need to order your packaging for a pen chip. I got 200 of the pink ones for $8 and 50 of the cactus ones for only $2.49. It's literally the best deal for low.
Worrying when you don't make a sale. So many of you say, I've just launched and I have not made one sale yet. Who cares? If this business is something that you want to do in the long term and you know it has the potential to work, why do you care about one sale here or there at the beginning? You're building something. You're creating a life that you want. Stop stressing about that sale. Do you want to know the best little secret of business? Actually, of anything. The people that stick it out are the people that win. For every one part of an idea, you need 5 parts of perseverance. I just made that up. but it's true. Just stick it out. I promise you will get there. Don't give up.
First, my mom cuts all the fabric, and I mean all the fabric. And then I sew in the XXL fabric tags. And my mom is right beside me cutting. And I usually batch sew one step all at once to save time. And then the elastic. I put all the elastic through. I triple knot it to make sure it's super secure. So the last sewing step would be to sew the hole closed. So you have to use a matching color thread for this last step. This is probably my favorite part because it finishes off the stitch. But there's one more thread to cut, and my dad comes to save the day.
Okay.
And he staples all the paper tags onto each XXL scrunchie. So it's time to update my inventory on my site. This is a story I created for my Instagram to let my customers know. And I also created an email campaign. And yeah, that's how we restock.
Don't worry at all about the things they do or say. I love you anyway. You can twerk while in a split. You racking up them tips. Your body rocking, your booty popping. I'm proud to call you my bitch.
Watch this, y'all. It's my hidden talent. Oh, you want me to do it again?
I am healthy, I am wealthy, I am rich, I am that bitch. I am gonna go get that bag, and I am not gonna take your shit. I am protected, well respected, I'm a queen, I'm a dream. I do what I wanna do, and I'm who I wanna be. Cause I am
like the Atlantic, and I'm going down like the Titanic.
Yeah, I'm still going down. I'll be falling for a long time. I so innocent, I didn't know you had a bad side. Yeah, it's kinda weird, these emotions all attacking me. I don't want the answer, but how long this been happening? Deep down
I'm mad at Disney. They tricked me. Had me wishing on a shooting star. But now I'm 20-something. I still know nothing about who I am or what I'm not. So call me a pessimist, but I don't believe in it. Finding a true love is just bullshit. Cause I felt sad love, I felt bad love. Sometimes happy love, so I end up giving up. My fairy grandma warns me
guilty of this too, but I feel like small businesses always show their biggest orders on TikTok. Packaging videos of multiple items, but in reality, sometimes, if not most times, you get orders for just one item. And I just wanted to let you know that even if you just buy only one item from my shop, I'm still grateful for you. You are helping me pursue my dreams.